as I'll double check it as well. But yeah, that's going to take effect about 2 minutes time from now, and hopefully those change it up. So we just changed intake service. Hopefully that corrects the issues that people seem to be happening. Miguel running away here in the middle lane from Era, but looks like everyone's going to be hunky-dory.
Yeah, but Era, man, look at his farm. He is not having a good game right now. 0-3-0. Can't find any lane to get any farm in. Like, whoever he goes up against, he's always risking the chance of dying. Whether it's Lifestealer, the Slark, or the Invoker. So, this is really, really poor for Era here.
Well, you kind of knew it. That's why I thought it was going to be like an aggressive trial lane. With an aggressive trial lane, you got chances for kills. You got chance for momentum. You've got a lot of space being made for yourself. But they just didn't seem to have the same level of security in having him on that off lane. And now Maz waiting to pounce again here in the middle lane. It's just going to take Era.
Oh, no.
Almost got himself in range.
I think he should have tried for the purge instead of the disruption. It has a bit, actually, much longer range than the disruption. So he was trying to get that, and Luna was able to see him and just casually walk away.
Might have been trying to save that one for a rainy day, like now. Bottom lane, Miguel's just running in. He starts the dark pack before Ryze even looking to get the sun. The sunstrike's going to come in. That'll kill him off right there. Again, Fader able to pick up a kill. And Miguel not only healing up through Ultimate, but also healing up through the mech, which again has been built up on Fader. So add another one to Nahaz's counter.
It's so cool, the mech invoker. I'm a fan. I like it.
The funny thing is, though, like if you look at the last game, like we knew the timing of the push that would be coming out from Fnatic. We knew there'd be a level of pressure being applied. But in this game, like it wasn't the same. But again, though, he decides to build it. And they add the pressure themselves. So all tier 1 towers now down for Fnatic with that bottom tower going down. So they're the ones who have the control. They're the ones who have the strength during these early team fights and engagements.
The utility invoker. And you know, this is not, I don't think this is possible without the Crystal Maiden as well on Sigma's side. Like the aura from the Crystal Maiden aura just helps this invoker so much. Normally we see him like run out of mana rather quickly, and like mech would just totally destroy his mana pool, but with the CM, this is definitely possible.
Alright.
So I will see it picked up. How is the lag or the stream coming along?
No idea. Like, seriously, I'm looking over my screens and everything is absolutely 100% fine, but I'm not getting any stream back from Twitch.
Oh boy. Huh. Looks like Trixie, Honey, just trying to make some space, and he did, like we said, bought the boots of travels.
It's his style, man.
Yeah.
He tries to always be a space maker when it comes to the Batrider.
Yeah. But, like, it's so hard to try and create space here. Like, Lifestealer and Slark are so difficult to kill. Even if you do grab them, they have such high chance of just getting out.
We're going to get on Trixie. Disruption, catch up, he got it even with the creep wave coming in close. They're going to follow with the purge and lifesteal. It's not enough damage to bring down Trixie at this point with the Venomancer TP in. It's definitely not going to happen.
Bottom
at the same
lane.
Time, Fnatic,
bottom
yeah, they're pincering around, but Fader, he's going to try and bring down Era. The Force Spirits are still going hard to work. He's managed to avoid the stun. Honey now able to get the last up, and Miguel comes in, takes the last hit. Fader, mech charge goes again, keeping him alive. Dark Pact actually melts down Arise, and it buys the space for Fader, the man who was being attacked from the north, south, and west. He now comes back to attack from the west to the east, going on to Trixie, who's held inside the leash, and Miguel, the perfect arrival, the perfect timing.
What teamwork. And Fata, I can't believe he's alive. You know, I was just watching the Slark, and I'm like, yeah, he's just gonna get these two guys, and I look to the other side, and here it is, Fata healing up, back to full health now, out of that fight. I thought he was, like, for surely dead, but, yeah, the stun. Like, Leshak only has level 1 stun as well. No wonder it was so difficult for him to hit on the Invoker.
It looks like our stream is back up again.
Huh.
I'm hoping it survives a little bit longer.
Dire's top tower is under attack.
Yeah, I can also see.
Oops, I gotta get back on the camera work as I'm trying to write support messages. That spree now just ended by Luna. Looks like it wasn't that easy for him though, and well, lifesteal just raged TB back out again.
Yeah, the Sark didn't have the ultimate up when he was going in there, and he just got ulti done by the Luna, so kinda sucks. You're only invincible when you have that ult. It's gonna be a tier 2 tower on the bottom lane, and Bristleback actually, they're gonna glyph it up and TP in the Bristleback here, so maybe they're gonna be able to get it denied.
Can't get it denied. When you disrupt it up like that, you can't really do much, and when you're purged up, Trixie can't really chase up either.
Yeah,
and now TP out by Mad. He doesn't have the damage to kill off Mad, not in time at least. And now you see Soshka as well as pass on the rotate. You push out the bottom lane, and they're looking for someone from Fnatic to come up towards the jungle just to farm up. Era is obviously the main man they're searching for. While Miguel just found Trixie. Shadowblade attack starts up, leeches him up. He's just trying to pull out the essence for now, make it 6 points pull of essence. Triggers out the ulti. He's got Pounce and Dark Pack back off cooldown again, but he's not going to commit it any further while they have managed to find Era. So they rotate through the jungle to find him. Now Era, quick loser beam. He does not have enough damage. He realized he couldn't kill off the lifesteal, so just trying to pick up the Crystal Maiden at the same time. No rage available just yet. Trix is going to come in. Nice Gale. Hearing the Lasso, Stunstrike, Arise. Decide to stick around to try and fight this one up. Harney lassoed inside the pit with Roshan. Past Trixie. Still trying to chase him down for the moment, and he should be able to pick up this kill. One more attack, and he's got it. Meanwhile, back over the Slark, teaming up onto the Venomancer. We're going tip for tat. Fader comes in with the Meg Charge. He needs a Cold Snap. He's already just used it on Trixie, taking a lot of damage. Earn Charge as well. Trixie should tick out from this as he runs up towards the high ground and away from the rest of the team. But Miguel just pounces.
Yeah, it looked pretty decent for Fnatic until the Invoker came into the fight. So, like, they got two for two, which is actually really good for Fnatic if they can get any kind of trade at all. But after the Bristleback, that is all.
Mm-hmm.
Fnatic anymore, and that's a lot of damage being done to the tier 2 tower too now. Last game, we obviously saw the BKB being picked up by the Invoker before he made the book 3, but that was of course against Pugna, and this game he doesn't need it, so just gonna go for that book.
Miguel, Arise is dead. Sunstrike's on the way, and even if the stun was able to connect, it wouldn't have done anything because he triggers a Dark Pact at like almost the perfect time for when the stun would connect on him.
Mm-hmm.
And now with that, Sigma will go in for Roshan.
Yep, and now, Sigma, they're just playing the objective game at this point. Like, they're just doing everything so naturally. Nothing feels forced at all. They're getting the ganks they can with the Lifestealer, the Slark, wherever they see Fnatic come, and then just taking the towers. It's just really, really good play in general, coming from Sigma, both last game and this game. Really impressed. Has fallen to the
Radiant. Well, continue to be impressed, man. Trixie being ganked up by Miguel. Needs a little bit more support, though, if he's really going to pull that one off. Pass, even though he's moving fast with those face boots and the Crystal Maiden, he's about to finish a 4-staff, and then he'll be there in time. But then Harney needs his 4-staff as well. He's got ring. Literally all he has for his 4-staff for the moment. With a Blink Dagger and BTs, at least he can jump around the place, but he can't drag anybody back and give Fnatic the upper hand in positioning. And now Mad. Okay, does he want to have a crack at this? I thought for a moment he might consider it, but then again, considering it's only a Crystal Maiden, and Slark is in the neighborhood, not enough to kill off the Bristleback. They need to have the Invoker there as well, or Lifestealer. Sentry Ward's down. Okay, Miguel, now he knows that Sentry Ward is freshly done. Shadow Blade's up, and the Creepway followed him down. So he backed up.
He actually finished Necro Book 3 now as well. 2k more.
Arise is dead. I assume he was attempting a stack. It definitely wasn't a farm, because Lestrade can't farm up an ancient stack.
Oh, no, for sure. Like, they wanted to do something to try and get this Luna back in the game, but it's just so difficult. Look, the only place that they can farm is like this, right now. And even then, can you see that?
Yeah, I'm looking at your zone, man, and there's only one creep camp, and even then you're only drawing in, like, half of this one creep camp, which Fnatic are allowed to farm up. And Era's going to go down again, so he's even dying inside the box. And up on top lane, Harney, open wounds up, there's no 4-staff away, and he's slowed down and attacked. 21-8.
Bottom lane. What? Look how much damage the Invoker dealt to the tier 3 tower.
He's unstriking. He's having a guess. Arise is going to miss. But how much... Oh. Wow! Is under
attack. Yep.
How is he doing dropped. That? He's got level 3 Necro Book.
Yes. Yes, the books, then the summons and Alacrity on the book. And they just wailed on the tier 3 tower while Fnatic was trying to, you know, run around to try and save the Luna or the top guy, whoever it is, and try Bristle to TP back in time.
Bristle's dead. He doesn't have enough mana to really escape from this. Miguel's got to leech him in here for a moment. The Sunstrike's coming down too.
Boom.
It's perfectly on Trixie. There's a pounce off cooldown but in 1 second time. He's too slow. He's too slow, Miguel. Is under
attack. He's getting slowed down by the Banner Wards, but yeah. Like, it's such irrelevant kills, I think, at this point. Like, Fnatic's base is just melting anytime the Invoker gets there.
I love this from Matt. He disrupts himself over in a corner so he can send a couple of illusions up. I don't know if that was like a, oh my god, where I'm about to get blinked on kind of moment. Or if that was a, I will use my illusions to bait moment. Bottom tower's gone. Maybe not. The Glaives are cleaning up a decent amount. Sunstrike's on the way in. I don't know exactly what that was searching for. Because everyone's got pretty full life. So it's like, what position? Miguel wants to go mid. The sentry ward's down here, but obviously Miguel at some point doesn't also care about sentry wards. Leech is in, and he got it. He got it on Trixie. Support's on the way in. Now triggers off the Dark Pact. Stun's already been thrown. And Pass rotating over. Four staffs in. Nova's first. Frostbite second. Purge is still available. Another leech from Miguel. Call snap. Support comes in from Fader, but it's Slark who is the one to claim the kill again. And that takes him 10-5 on the kill count as well. He is ripping through the KDR. And then bottom lane, Miguel tries to have a crack at Arise.
They got the tower as well, the tier 3 tower. And Honey, he's looking for a jump here. They smoked up for this.
He's got 4 staff, so now he can finally do the job he was meant to do.
Has to be Fata.
Yep, got him. 4 staff him up, right, drag him back inside. First stun, Venomancer, slow him down, they got him.
I wonder if he'll buy back. And since Batrider ult is on cooldown, try and push the base.
He might buy back for a Sunstrike. He might buy back for the Sunstrike. Sorry, just watching it rise all the way. No, he's not going to. Where was the commitment, Hani? Where was the Fnatic buyback?
You mean the Sigma? The Fata? Invoker? You're so used to Hani playing the Invoker.
Sorry, yeah, I am. Sorry, I keep doing it, man.
Yeah, that's not a Hani Invoker.
No, this is like next level. Then again, like Hani's Invoker is pretty damn good as well.
Yeah.
Take nothing away from him.
Slime. He does have his Lincolns finished up now, flying to him, and Lifestealer has Desolator finished up. Like, this is so much base push coming from Sigma.
Even beyond base push, you got so much more like direct hero damage. And now he's going to open up on Era. Rage is up. That takes 5 hits to kill off the Luna.
All right, 260 or more.
I don't know if you're going to get out of this one. Trixie, like, Infest. It's going to actually bring him in closer. If there's another open wounds, which there is, he just starts attacking to the back of Trixie. But Trixie turns towards him. Lasso, it goes on Pass. The only hero they know that can kill off pretty fast. And Pass, he does go down. They're using the Pulse and everything else. But at the same time, whoa! Oh, that little track's done. It buys the space. Disruption buys him more as well as the Mech Charge. Arias dies the Call Snap. Sunstrike, it's perfectly on the Venomancer.
Wow.
Hani's still here, but he's running out of teammates quickly. Trixie's outside the base, and Miguel, he's now going to have a crack. Leeches him in. Trixie's locked in. Hani's on the way back out of here. Open wounds up, blinks away, but the GG is called, and Sigma will make it a very good game for them, going 2-0 and getting themselves an easy berth, if we judge these games, into the grand final of the Pinnacle Sports Pro-Am. Well, they'll face up against the winner of our next game. We have ourselves Americans. Pretty Boy Swag going up against Roxkiss. Should be some good fun.
Pretty Boy Swag. I know a few of their players. I also met them one time at a MLG LAN. So let's see how they're doing and how their training has been coming along.
Well, they've already been putting out some decent results recently, but we might leave it to Zoe and Mel to talk about that one later on. For now, though, man, we're going to have ourselves a break. We do still have the D2CL Season 2 qualifiers going, which Roskits is playing in. So when they're finished their game there, we will jump ourselves in. But it means we have about an hour's delay before we'll be coming back with our next live stream. So I'm going to drop the live stream down again and then bring it back up again for rebroadcast purposes. And I'm going to see if I can work out, too, what the hell went wrong during our last game. So, yeah, stay tuned, everyone. We'll see you all back here in about an hour for our next game, which will be Pretty Boy Swag going up against Roxkiss, the winner of which will come back tomorrow to play in the grand final for the lion's share of the €10,000, which is up for grabs here up against Sigma. Stay tuned. You'll find out who it is.